good, actually.
Yeah, it is.
So I know Dalung and Confucius. There are spaces. They are. They
yeah.
Those are two
well,
spaces.
I mean, my Sega is playing.
Mojo Hans also.
Mojo
spaces
Hans is. Yeah, he's
so
a spaces.
A lot of spaces
we
on the Cologne
like
team.
Have 4 or 5 spaces. Dalung is one. GCB plays a very good Sheik and a Marth, but also a very good Fox. My Sega, I think he's sticking to Captain Falcon or maybe Samus, because he's grinding Samus a few weeks ago. But now we have Mojo Hans, and who was the other player?
Confucius?
No, no, this is not Confucius. I'm sure.
Dalung?
No, it isn't.
we just missed it.
Yeah. Well, we'll see it soon.
Yeah.
In a couple of seconds.
All right, but we're getting into the first match. Mojo Hans.
Mijusu, okay.
First
so
Mijusu.
It's a Falco Ditto. We have Falco.
Ah, okay. So a lot of pillaring at first.
Yeah, I mean as always.
As always. In the Falco Ditto, you just pillar, laser.
Then F smash.
Then F smash. Yeah, you want to finish it off with the F smash to send them off and try to get an edge guard.
Yeah.
All right, read the roar in. It was really good.
Yeah.
Ooh, actually an unsafe down air. Maybe one of them is gonna shine on the shield a little bit, as Falco is a little bit harder than Fox.
Yeah,
mix up.
I think it's great.
But if they do high aerials, you can really shine on the shield, and this should be. It has a lot of combo potential.
Yeah. Now it's pretty even.
Yep.
Mijusu with a slight lead.
Yep. Mijusu is the red Falco.
Yeah.
Mojo Hans is the neutral one. Yes.
It could have been a kill, but didn't. Got
He doesn't want to go out for it. Nice OB, really, to grab the ledge while Mijusu was hanging onto it. Okay, Mojo Hans, side B back to the stage. That's below the ledge. Yep,
and that's
secure.
The down smash. So, Mojo's leading, but a back air could mean anything or in there.
Yeah, gets the roll in. Good
very
catch.
Fast, quick kill.
You know what actually surprises me? None of these Falcos actually vetoed Fountain of Dreams, so they're both okay with it.
Yeah, that was I was wondering too, because you know, usually
one of them might
Spaces,
just say
Spaces ban Fountain, but
lately Foxes have been warming up to it, but I know Falcos still are a bit sour about the stage. Good lasers.
Yeah, amazing spacing by Mijusu. Very nice combo.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, okay, that's good damage. Nice.
He tried for the hard read.
Yep.
Nice lasers to keep Mojo Hans in shield and very good F smash.
Oh, the call out with the F smash. It might have been on a reaction. It might have been a predict. I have no clue.
Yeah, maybe both.
Yeah. Yeah, it's always a little bit of a mixer.
Yeah. Very nice back air by Mojo Hans.
Completely even, 0%. Oh, nice pivot down there. Shine, shine, shine. Who's gonna get it? So the first shine is gonna do so much damage on either of them.
Yeah, 48%.
Yeah, 95. Still has positional advantage. All right, now Mojo Hans is in the positional advantage. And it turns around so quickly, and there's the stock, actually.
It was very quick.
You see, in Falco Ditto, the positional advantage is basically everything because the character is so heavy on it.
Yeah, it is.
So you really don't want to overcommit on any options and show away your advantage on that position.
Okay, so.
Back throw.
Mojo Hans is trying his best to stay alive.
Yep, he really should for his.
No! Oh my god!
And that makes it a 2-stock lead instead of the 1-stock you should have expected for either of a player.
Well, that is pretty good for Team Cologne.
Oh, really? Yeah. Next up is.
Keza. Yes, he's a very good Sheik player.
A Sheik player, okay.
I don't know about his knowledge against Spaces, but I mean, everyone knows.
Well, yeah, everyone should know how to play against Spaces. Falco is still difficult, but at least Falco should have some knowledge on how to play versus them. So it should be fine. They're actually switching seats. So one of them might not have been as comfortable in one seat or another. Battlefield, pretty even. All right, no vetoes.
Okay, this is.
Alright, so 2 stocks on Mojo Hans versus the 4 of Keze. Keze has to at least try to bring the lead of 2 stocks down to 1. At least 1 stock.
At least, you know, like, make it even.
Yeah, even might be hard. If these two players are really even skilled, 2-stocking is so difficult. It should really. He could be looking for Gimps as well on Falco. Gimps always work on Falco. if you just get him below the ledge, just drop down back air.
Yeah, true. Okay, Mojo Hans.
What are they doing? No, you shouldn't start Mojo Hans.
Okay. I think they will still play on Dreamland after all.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, yeah.
Okay. They agreed on Dreamland. I don't know. This is maybe not as good for Falco.
Yeah, I mean, Sheik's survival is very important for her. Mm-hmm. Also, since her recovery isn't the best,
yep.
I think Dreamland, especially with the wall jumps
yep.
at the edge, will have to have a little bit of mix-up for the recoveries.
Yep.
Mojo's trying to shine.
Oh, okay. This is
chase.
The first deck chase is missed. We'll see if Gaze can actually
very defensively with lasers right now.
Yeah.
Since they're in the lead stock-wise.
Yeah, this is something you notice on Dreamland. People say this stage is relatively bad for Falco because his recovery does not get helped, but it's a big stage. But his laser game is enhanced, really, because you get so much space to use it.
Especially if you laser on both platforms,
yep.
you cover everything, so...
Yep. Alright. Playing a little bit by the edge. I'm not sure if that's the safe option, but... If he feels like he's comfortable on the ledge, you should really go for it. Oh, he extends the combo, that's really good. Okay, Kaze bringing the stock back, bringing the lead back by one stock at already.
Very nice shield by Kaze.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Mojo Hunt is pressuring Kaze so hard with lasers.
Yeah, but I don't feel like Kaze is cracking too much because, you know, he's only having 71%. It's not too much.
Yeah, he could take it at 4 stocks.
Oh, really nice DI down. Grab. Back throw? Okay.
Oh my god.
The down smash, he actually went over the down smash.
But still got
hit. Okay, he can make it back. Yeah, back air.
Yeah. I think...
Is this the magic of Dreamland coming through?
142%.
Yeah, he would have died on any other stage from those back airs.
He's trying to get the kill so hard.
Yep.
Back down.
Okay, back throw, also good.
Oh my god.
Okay, yeah, well, okay. Mojo Hans, what are you doing?
This is the back air.
That could
so
have been,
risky.
Yeah, that could have been really bad for him.
Yeah, that's it.
Alright, Mojo Hans takes the stock for his team.
96%.
So his team is definitely in the lead at least. Even if he loses the stock now.
Yeah.
So he got that advantage for the next player. That's really good.
Yeah, now Kaze has to quickly seal the
This should be it. It's a Falco. Yep. Alright, little fist bump. Next player is coming in.
So we're 16 to 15 stocks.
I think that's Dalung, right?
Dalung is playing for the Cologne team.
Oh
no, he isn't. He's playing for Münster, actually.
Is it?
No, this is Cologne, since Mojo Hans was playing for Cologne too.
We'll see right now.
Yeah.
Dalung for Cologne, yes. For Munster, we still have Kaze. So yeah, Dalung coming in, he's the Fox player.
Yes.
Yeah. So Fox versus Sheik.
He started actually
Stadium.
Pretty early.
Okay, Stadium gets Fido'd.
Okay.
So if they reroll now and get FD, yep.
Oh my god.
You see Kaze like,
yeah,
oh
his
my
face,
god.
He knew it. RNGesus.
I had a feeling this would happen.
Yeah, commentator's curse, kind of.
Yeah. I'm a Fox man myself, so
I
may be a little bit biased. No, so Kaze has to lose one stock.
Yeah.
Dalung, yeah. So tell me about Dalung.
Well, he started 2 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Not very long ago, and he began playing with the very good players, you know.
Yeah.
And he had a lot of difficulties at the start, but as you play with better players, you start playing the game better and better,
yep.
much faster, you know. So he quickly became one of the best players in Cologne.
Yeah, that's really
like
good.
Only 2 years. It was crazy.
Yeah. I played him on an Avalon, actually.
Mm-hmm.
And he beat me, so I know he's a good player.
Yeah.
But yeah, he's a really good Fox.
Fox has a lot of options here on FD, like Wave Shines and Up Smash.
Yeah, can Wave Shine over the whole stage. Grabs Lee too a lot because she gets thrown into the air. She doesn't have a lot of options to come down.
Yeah, no platforms.
Yeah.
That's a problem for Sheik at the moment.
Yeah, also for recovery, but also for juggles.
Yeah.
But you know, it can also help her when she does a forward tilt, etc. Fox at least cannot go to the platform. But yeah, this stage is definitely in Dalung's favor. Let's see if he can actually reclaim the lead for his team. Extend the lead, that might be it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Stallone trying to get the kill.
Yeah. He's playing really good at the edge.
Ooh,
well,
oh, very good fair by Keza.
Yeah, actually catches the tournament winner by Dalung. I don't think he wanted to do that.
And no one wants to.
No one wants to do that. Oh, nice.
Very nice.
Okay, gets
double
the grip. Wave shine,
yeah,
wave
that's
shine.
That's the wave shine we were talking about.
Very good option.
I would have preferred an up smash,
yeah,
to be honest. But
yeah. Yeah, I think he was just out of range, so that's why
he
might have done that.
He wanted to get him off stage anyways. So.
Yeah. Okay, good smash DI to get out of the grab range.
Yeah, Dalung playing
nice.
Very
yeah, he's
patiently.
Really zoning him.
Great dash dances.
Yep.
Oh, very nice grab by Keza.
Yeah, he just runs in, YOLO grab.
Back air. This is the back air. Down tilt.
Oh, does not wait for a sport dodge. Shine. Oh, a little bit too late on it. Okay. Yeah, crouch cancel. That's really what I want to see. Crouch cancel is so good in this matchup. You can get crouch cancel down tilts, crouch cancel jabs, up smash, shined.
Yeah, Keza is trying his best to get the kill off Dalung, but he won't.
Yeah, well, at least he got him out of those crouch cancel percent.
Yes.
You want to get him over 40, 50%, then Sheik's aerials at least knock him down. And you have some options.
Yeah, you see that they're both respecting each other at the moment.
Yeah, really.
Being very spacious.
Oh, the jab! Oh, crouch cancel! Nice drill retreating, that was really good. He actually baited him out.
Very nice back air. He gets back
what
on
a grab.
Stage. Grabs and F. That's it! Dalung down another stock.
Yep.
Now we have Keza and Dalung with both.
So basically what Keza wants to do is take one more stock.
Yeah.
Two stocks would be nice. A Gimp could really net him another stock.
Yeah, Gimp would be amazing.
Yeah.
But I don't think that Dalung.
Yeah, he's playing too safe, man. He won't really get grabbed at the edge. No, up smash. Okay, up smash would also see the deal.
Yes.
But he could have DI'd down and do the arms attack. So.
Yeah. I mean, Dalung wasn't baited once, you know, like Gimped once.
Definitely,
so he's
yeah.
He's playing too defensively to get
he's
killed.
Playing really safe at this point. He wants to keep the lead in his team's favor. Up throw? No, okay. Tries to get the edge guard again.
Very nice.
Sheik on the edge is also really bad. Does not have that many options.
Yeah, especially if you're pressured.
Yeah, especially if you can really get a pressure on him.
Great grab. Misses the tech chase. Back air by Dalung.
Ooh, it's for it.
Oh my god.
Three spot dodges. The baits are real. But he doesn't get it.
Empty jumps were crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah, Dalung just needs. Yeah, that's it.
Jab up smash. Alright, Dalung extending it by one stop. 14 to 12. That's really nice.
Yes.
The Cologne team is up.
Let's see who Münster is going to throw in next.
Yeah, Münster still has the powerhouse of Slim Shady. He's one of the better players in Germany.
Yes, he's the greatest Mario I've ever seen.
The greatest Mario? Scorpion Master? No?
Maybe,
okay.
Maybe we'll see a ditto between Scorpion Master and
yeah, one day. If Slim Shady ever goes to the
crazy.
USA.
But yeah, he's doing an amazing job as Mario. And
so I already see Slim Shady standing up.
Yes.
Will he be the one going in? They also have Kla Bauchermann and Super Captain Young. So what's he doing? He's putting the towel back. I think Slim Shady is coming in, yeah.
Yes.
So do you know maybe Slim Shady, Dalung, do they play or?
Yes, they play a lot.
Oh,
and,
really?
Sometimes you can see them practicing on stream together.
Oh,
and,
okay.
Also, at the other monthlies we have here in Dortmund and in Nordrhein-Westfalen, they play each other a lot. So
okay,
both
so
should know each other.
So Dalung
very
has
well.
At least has the Mario experience.
Yes.
Because I expect Slim Shady has all the Fox experience he needs, but the other way around is usually not the case.
Yes.
Most Foxes have no idea what the Mario does.
Yeah, the problem with Dalung is I've also played him. I played Luigi, and he had a lot of difficulties playing against me since he didn't really know what to do in the Luigi matchup.
Ah.
And I mean, he won both games, but it was really close, to be honest. And
not what you expect of his caliber. Okay.
So I was pretty surprised. So maybe we'll see Slim Shady in action.
Yeah.
Putting out all his knowledge against Spaceys and
Slim Shady also played with the Ice a lot, which is the best Fox in Germany third in Europe. Yes. So he should have the Fox experience down.
He really should.
Yeah. Quickly sending out a tweet, I'm about to play.
I think he's choosing his music.
Yeah, probably.
Playing I with wonder what he listens to. Like, you know the Superstar theme from Mario?
Maybe he does
all the time, you know? 24/7.
Well, you know, maybe he tries to save that for when he actually needs it. When he's down in the set, he puts it up.
And he turns into this Super Mario.
Yeah, the real Super Mario. So the Loom 2 stocks, 4 for Slim Shady. He has to bring back the lead. 12 to 14 stocks. 3 players left on each team after the Loom for the Cologne team.
We have the fist bump and the match is starting.
Yeah.
The Loom spacing really great. Trying not to get hit.
Yeah, the down air into up air. I know that's a really... Mario does that quite a lot, down air into up air,
it's
right?
It's a pretty popular combo, so... It does quite a lot of damage.
It does damage and it also leads into positional advantage, really.
Misses the down smash.
So both players are playing really safe. We haven't really seen a combo. These are all straight
also
hits.
Also, we see a lot of shields coming up.
Yep.
Very nice back air by the Loom, keeping on the pressure.
The Loom's aerials are really safe. I think Slim Shady tried to shield grab the latest one, but it didn't work. Just fast falling and shining after it too quick.
Slim already off stage, but he gets to come back.
Up throw.
Very nice up smash.
Okay, okay. The Loom gets the tech. He knew that was coming. That was really good. Okay.
A little bit of mix-up.
Caps the edge. That's a trade we'll take.
Well, that's a GameStop trade.
Yep.
That's one for
Yeah, that's bad for Slim Shady.
Yeah, it is.
The Loom just ripped him off, man. Slim Shady jumping around a bit, not throwing out hitboxes.
Very nice grab.
Yeah.
Misses the fireball. The Loom knew what was coming, so he waited it until Slim put out the fireball so he can recover safely.
Yeah. So as good as Fox's nair is, Mario's nair just got shield grabbed, so I don't think it's safe on shield at least.
Not really.
So I don't think Slim Shady wants to approach really as Mario. He doesn't really have the best approach option.
He's trying to approach a lot of with the down air.
Yeah, he's trying not to really approach as much as, well, he should not try to approach, but at least try to bait out the moves in front of him. And then punish accordingly.
But you see, Dalung is playing way too patient.
Yep.
He's taking his time, dash dancing, trying to get himself in a better position.
Yep.
And that's putting Slim Shady in a very bad position.
Okay, Slim Shady wants to take this without losing another stock. Because he wants to trade at least one for one. And actually more, but this could mean another stock. No, gets the super coin. Slowly wave dashing forward.
Amazing dash dances again.
Jab reset. Gets the follow up.
Up smash.
Now really nice. Catches
chance.
The shield drop.
Now it's his chance.
Okay. Dalung. Throwing out a fireball to keep him safe. Two. Grabs the edge again. Oh!
That's. Is that it? Amazing
Side B.
Recovery by Dalung.
Okay, Dalung makes it back to the stage. Neutral. Oh!
Wow.
Catches him with
a quick F smash. In his face.
Yep.
So now we're 12 to 11 stocks. I mean, compared to the first match, I think they were in a 4 or 3 stock lead.
Yeah,
and now it's only 1 stock.
Yeah, the lead has vanished. So Munster still has Super Cat Meow and Calabauto Man after Slim Shady.
Yes.
Köln still has. Let's see, Dalung just got defeated. So they still have GCB. Meister Jäger, right?
Yes.
And Confucius?
Yes.
Alright.
Confucius is a very good Falco player.
Yeah, oh, I see his controller rolling off.
Yeah,
he might be going in.
I would have thought that they would send Meister Jäger since he's a Captain Falco player. And I think
is
against floaties, I would prefer
a Captain
to
Falco.
Play. See?
Alright.
Because Slim Shady has the spacey knowledge,
but no.
Maybe not so much.
Yeah, but it is Confucius after all.
I see.
So Confucius.
Very interesting choice. Well, maybe they want to keep Meister Jäger, you know, to play it safe.
Yeah. So I'll tell you right now, I played Confucius today. He actually beat me. I feel upset.
Yes.
But I have to say he played really good. He is really good at controlling the lasers and coming in with the aerials at the right time. And Mario doesn't really have tools to deal with that as well.
Maybe
as
the cape, but...
Yeah, cape in neutral might
be...
Cape in neutral, if he misses, might be a really bad idea.
Slim Shady does not want to play on Yoshi's.
I mean, is there any particular reason you have an idea, or is it?
I mean, it's Falco's story after all.
Is it?
I mean,
I feel like Stadium might be just as bad, but okay, we'll get Slim Shady, who knows what he's doing.
Yeah, a little of tech skills show off.
Yeah, Slim Shady has to lose one stock at least. Drops down.
Neutral start.
So I feel like this stage is really good for Falco actually, because he can control a lot of the space. See, there's no top platform to retreat to.
Yes.
So he can shoot either.
Also cancel a lot of stuff on the platforms.
Yep.
Such as down air or maybe side B, putting a bit of mix up into the combos.
Okay, we lied.
That's the cape.
Yep, we lied.
Yeah, who will have actually thought that it could be so useful?
Yeah, cape.
But he isn't using it much, so I think he's only using it when he wants to play it safe or.
Yeah. Okay. Oh no, this could be stuck. Yep. Oh, nice.
Oh my god.
I can't believe he actually turned around. So I might have underestimated the cape. He is actually. It has a really good hitbox on it as well.
Yeah, especially, you know.
There you go.
He, isn't landing as fast as he will actually do.
Yeah.
So I don't think he's using it only to reflect the lasers, but also to take his time coming back on the stage.
Yeah, definitely.
And trying to bait out some of Confucius' moves.
Yeah. So I feel like Confucius' laser control might be a little bit stuffed on this Mario.
Yeah,
if
he's holding back. He's holding back actually, because he knows that Mario has the tool to reflect the lasers.
Yeah, apparently. Okay, up smash looking like Fox, taking lead. Confucius getting getting some attention from his boys. laughing at it. So Falco is really difficult to hit as well for Mario. He has such a quick high jump. Mario really can reach him up there.
He's using it to his advantage.
Yep.
Now we have a no pillar combo.
Yeah, Mario is a little bit more difficult to pillar.
Yeah, you know, as a Luigi player, I don't get pillared often.
Yeah.
I just fly around the whole stage.
Oh, nice feeling. Alright, Confucius losing his stock, but he got on 60%. Mario is at least.
Yeah, with a few quick back airs.
Oh, okay.
It could be.
Up smash!
Well, that was very surprising. I think it was.
Okay! Okay, no, it doesn't kill.
I think he wanted to like drop down up there.
Yeah, maybe.
Slim Shady trying his best to keep himself alive at 120%, playing very defensively.
Yeah, he's doing really well on the platforms as well with the fireballs, keeping himself safe there.
I mean, cape and fireballs seem to be a very good option to keep Falco off.
See, he doesn't really want to laser as much as anymore.
Yeah, he's kind of restricting him by having the cape.
Alright. Really nice. Just presses L, rolls up.
Can't come back on stage.
Yup.
And dies.
So Confucius is a little bit of a little bit extending this lead as well.
Yeah, I mean, you know, since you're leading, you don't have to rush anything.
Yep.
And especially on this transformation, which is very weird, you know, the cave can do some big damage, so I don't think that both players don't want to risk anything.
Yeah.
Very nice fireballs actually by Slim Shady.
Yeah, he's been really keeping. And not much has happened on this transformation either. Confucius really got no chance to work with the rocks transformation.
Yeah, I mean, Slim Shady should be able to get at least one more kill.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree on that.
I mean, the F smash is not very far away, I think.
A B? No punish. Ah, that should be a kill, right? Alright, so the lead has
10.
This is basically what he started with, right? One stock lead.
Yes. 62%, I think it should be doable.
Yeah.
If he doesn't get hit way too much.
Oh,
very nice chain grab. No punish, actually.
Yeah. The down air doing a lot of shield hits, but Confucius just refusing to let go of a shield. Ah, nice. Uses the side B to get to platform.
Yeah, Yeah, maybe if Slim Shady plays really well.
Jab reset, but he didn't really want to go for it.
I think it was way too risky for him.
Yep.
And he's trying. Oh my god.
He's been giving the edge for free. Maybe he should keep the edge as well.
That would be very hard.
Confucius was in a difficult position to really reach the edge quickly.
He's playing it safe. He won't get to the edge. Okay. The rock actually saves Slim. Yep.
I think Slim Shady was aware of this, so that's why he just wanted to air dodge to the center.
Yeah.
Just regain center stage.
Missed up smash. Twice. And we have the
Slim
down
Shady,
smash.
Yeah, he pops off. He knows this was basically what he wanted.
Well, that's the best thing he could do.
Yeah, what he can hope. Only thing he can hope for now.
More or less even stocks.
Yeah, so what he can hope for now is maybe just a back throw into a cape.
A
but
crazy gimp, but.
But Confucius knows
he's
this.
He's playing way too safe for anything to let him happen.
But maybe Slim Shady can use that for his advantage as well. No. Confucius takes out Slim Shady. He's fine with this. Confucius keeping the lead for his team. Versus Slim Shady,
but
which is
great job by both players actually.
Yep. So Slim Shady brought the lead a little bit back. Confucius kept the lead where Slim Shady brought it back. So in the end, Confucius and his team, Köln, are still in the lead. With one stop. Versus Super Cat Meow and Club Outer Man.
I think GCB will come.
No, okay. Confucius is still in. So either Super Cat Meow or Club
Right.
Oh, right. Club Outer Man.
He's a very nice Yoshi player, actually.
Is he a Yoshi? Ah, okay.
I think he'll play Yoshi. Yes.
Alright, that's really cool.
That's really great.
I just want to give.
We have had Avalancer against Däumling.
Yeah, I wanted to give a quick shout out to
that. That was crazy. Amazing. Yep. I mean, Däumling is my boy, coming, you know, from my region and so on.
Yeah.
And I'm playing for his crews, but I honestly have to say that Avalancer's game was so good.
Yeah, it was sick, right?
It was crazy.
He's really new on the Yoshi as well. He's only been playing Yoshi. He had a really great Sheik, but he has been playing Yoshi for only about 4 months or something.
I see. I didn't know that.
Yeah, but he's been really grinding the Yoshi.
Yeah, I saw him on Avalon 2.
Yeah, he beat Adam there as well, so that's
really
another, that's
job.
An upcoming Yoshi as well. So if you see, maybe the Netherlands will be the next team to play.
Ooh,
so
Club Outerman against Avalancer.
Hmm?
So you have Club Outerman against Avalancer, maybe.
If they win.
I don't know.
If they win, they might be. Oh, but I don't know if the team is going to play versus this team. But I wanted to say, if we find the Netherlands in the next match, we might be seeing Avalancer again to find this crazy Yoshi.
That would be cool.
Yeah. But first, we have this Yoshi, which is Club Outerman. The golden Yoshi.
I don't really know if Confucius has matchup knowledge against Yoshi. He's playing it really safe, keeping up his lasers and trying to do the usual pillar combos.
Yeah, let's see if Club Outerman actually has the knowledge of the Yoshi combos, which can rack on so much damage on spaces. X throw, okay. Alright, gets back on the stage.
Yeah.
So platforms are really good for Yoshis, right?
Yeah.
He can really
do anything. I mean, he can cancel on it.
Too bad. Yeah, he can cancel on it. He really just wants to wave dash over him all the time.
So he's put in a very difficult situation. He doesn't want to lose a stock.
Oh, he actually. Yeah. Oh, that's it!
And he seals it!
Wow, okay, Club Outerman seals it.
You know, I think that was because of the missing Yoshi knowledge by Confucius.
Mm-hmm.
He tried to recover as usual, but
the egg.
He won't let him.
Yep. Look at the egg.
Very great.
He upbeat either too
high.
Yeah, too late, I think.
Now we have Meister Jäger. So we have Yoshi against Captain Falcon.
Ooh.
A matchup you don't really see very often.
Yeah. So, what I said, Avalancer beat Adam, but it was Adam's Captain Falcon. So we'll see if this also is a good. If this is in.
Oh,
you
Samus.
Lied to me, man. Okay,
yeah, I told you he was grinding Samus.
Okay, we have
for
another.
For a few weeks.
All right.
Oh no, Captain Falcon. He changed. I'm not sure.
He's trolling us.
Yeah.
Okay. Captain Falcon.
He'll stick to Captain Falcon.
All right. That's his main.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, you saw he chose Samus, and the whole crew went like, hell no,
no, no.
don't you dare.
Ah, I see.
Yeah, four precious stocks.
Yep. Yeah, well, there are the two last players on each, One of the two last players.
Yes.
On each team. So to be starting off instantly, no hand warmers, no stocks gone, I hope.
Yeah.
Just get into the match instantly.
I think we've been playing the whole day, so
yep.
It won't really be necessary.
Yep. So I have actually no idea which stage would be a good idea, a bad idea.
I mean, Captain Falcon would like to prefer Yoshi's. Dreamland?
Yeah, I see him shaking his head. Nah, okay, no. Clubhouseman says nah. Nah. No Dreamland. And I agree, yeah, Dreamland, Captain Falcon lives for too long. That's fine.
Okay, found you. Very good stage for Yoshi, to be honest.
Well, nope. Okay, okay. Oh, both Fidos are gone.
No, yeah, Yoshi will have been so much advantage.
Yeah.
Okay, FD.
Oh, can be good for Club Ultimate.
You know, platforms you to cancel platform. On and so on.
Oh, you really just have to use your ground moves, your aerials, get just a little bit of the weave back abilities of Yoshi.
Yeah.
That's one of
but
his greatest
strengths.
He's
doing a great job. My Sega started. Oh my god, the tick!
Yeah, nice meteor cancer.
Oh.
Yoshi! There he goes.
My Sega started out very good, but
yeah,
Clubhouseman got deleted way too fast.
Yeah, that stock was really good. The combo was pretty sick. The egg throws.
Yeah, Clubhouseman is taking his time. Oh no! Misses. How unfortunate.
Well, you know, at least he had one stock lead. It's not too bad. Nice parry. Parry on the knee. That's really good.
So
up tilt, following, up airs.
Nice.
Oh, he read the read. That's a knee. Oh, nice, really good cancel.
Oh my god.
That was really close, actually.
Yeah, they're trying to style on each other.
Do these players even know each other?
Yeah, but not really. You know, it's like they know who each other are, but oh my god,
nice,
crazy
nice.
Tech. And immediately reacted with an up B.
Yep.
So it's back air, very back. Even. Back air sealed the stock for
My
Sega.
These crews are so even, actually.
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, it started off with a huge disadvantage for Team Cologne.
Yeah, huge might be a bit of an overstatement.
Well,
it was really sizable. Three stocks is a lead, as they say. All right, nice. Down tilt? Nope.
I say you are doing a very good job at racking up the damage while being in a huge percentage disadvantage.
Definitely, he hasn't really gotten hit by Clubhouseman. Knee?
Crazy.
Should that be?
No.
Wow, okay. Maybe he should have tried to edgeguard at least.
Yeah, they're both playing a bit cocky, you know? Like, trying to disrespect each other.
Okay, down smash on the shield.
Very patient shield by My Sega.
Yeah. Alright. Clubhouseman taking the stock, but taking 120 in return, so that's a little bit of a... This could result in a one-stock disadvantage in the end.
Oh my god.
Wow. Meister Jaeger is putting on the... he's trying to disrespect him a little bit, trying to get into his mind, maybe.
Maybe he's trying to get him more offensive or...
Yep. Oh, that was almost really good back air. Yeah,
he tried to read with the stomp.
Mm-hmm. Oh, down tilt. Down tilt could maybe... Ah, okay, good. Yeah, Yoshi's down tilt sense is such a weird angle. That might be one of the best game tools he has.
Oh, very nicely.
The worst DI he could possibly have.
That's it.
Maybe he tried to tech it on the stage, but that's a two-stock advantage actually for Meister Jaeger.
Well, we thought it was just a one-stock advantage.
Yeah.
But...
It was really good, and as well on the meteor cancel.
Yeah.
And the retreat on the forward smash, wow. So the last player, Supercat Meow. How much work will he put in? That's a real question.
To put a lot of work.
Yeah, six stocks. Supercat Meow versus Meister Jaeger and GCB. So in your expert opinion on the German players, is it doable?
Supercat Meow has a wide range of characters. Mm-hmm. So he's playing Samus, Marth, Fox, Falco, Sheik, he's playing everything. So we first have to look and see what character he picks, mm-hmm. and after that I can tell you maybe if he has a chance or not.
Because which character was GCB again? Falco or Fox?
Yeah, I mean he plays Marth and Falco. Oh, we have a Captain Falcon ditto.
Alright, Yoshi story, do you agree on that?
Yes.
I assume.
I mean it's the best possible stage for both players.
Yeah, they like... probably, most Falcons like Yoshi story a lot. Falco! So, two stocks off for Meister Jäger.
Yeah, Meister Jäger playing with the end of story tag. Yep. He's a great friend of him.
Alright. Alright, are they ready?
Yeah, start.
Yep.
Super Tech Chase? No. Going in very quick.
So I already saw he's... Is Super Cat Meow a fan of tech chasing? Because I saw him go for the hard read with the stomp.
Yeah, I mean, most Captain Falcon players are fans of tech
okay,
chasing.
There you go. He did it with the stomp again. But at this time it did work.
I expected a knee.
Okay, that's... not a stop yet. Back air. Weak back air, actually.
Randall.
Retreat. Yeah. Goodbye, Chris Super Cat Meow, to go
16%.
Out so early. So this is the way to go about. If you can four stock Meister Jäger, get another stock without losing any, then it's really doable actually, right?
I mean it's even then.
Yep.
Oh my god!
We just
no.
Okay.
That was
Falcon somehow
very close.
He grabs the hatch somehow, but he's in a bad position thanks to it. All right, gets the ground. Down smash.
Down smash.
Down smash.
Oh no, very unfortunate.
Alright, Meister Jäger. He tried to go for the gold there.
The town chant.
Can you explain
it's
this?
It's an insider. A lot of smashers play Mafia online.
Ah.
And so a lot of people, when town wins in the team speak or in the Discord, we chant town.
It's harder for town to win, right?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
I mean, they get killed off each.
It's only for Berlin's.
I see.
Then I don't know why they were chanting down, but okay.
Ah. Yeah, I think GCB will use Marth.
Fox? He's thinking about it. Finding his color.
Okay.
They're going instantly into it. Which stage should he go to? Or which stage would he get, of course? And Vito?
I mean, final destination will be...
Yep, instantly LRA start away from Fountain of Effort final. A stadium,
okay.
Yeah, okay.
Now, it's a neutral stage.
Yeah, it's acceptable for Captain Falcon. I mean, he might have preferred Yoshi's?
Yes.
Or Battlefield, but...
He wanted to get off the quick kills.
Ah, okay, he keeps going for the stomp in place. People, yeah, I don't think I don't think GCB is gonna do that again.
Don't really think so.
Oh! Okay. Super Cat Meow is actually really, really good with his Captain Falcon.
I've never seen him playing Captain Falcon, so that was really strange.
Yeah, he's
at
doing
first,
really
but he's doing a great job.
And it's shine. Okay, gets a grab. Gets the up B on him, nice. Alright, GCB taking his time to tech chase, really good.
Very nice hex dash.
Yep. That's... No,
oh,
he
punish.
Misses. Yeah,
no
he misses
punish.
The grab the wrong way. Super Cat Meow, he was doubting himself.
One smash will seal it for both players.
A neutral air and... Yeah.
Yes.
Captain Falcon edge guard is pretty easy to do as Fox.
Yeah.
Should really be a no-brainer, but... Oh, no!
Very patient by Super Cat.
Yeah, but he leaves the edge open, so GCB can just go to the edge easily. Here again. Okay.
Oh, very nice. That was great.
Yeah. I think GCB also missed the sweet spot, what he was trying to go for, but, you know, super good coverage by Meow. Oh, no, don't get... what happened there?
I was expecting something high.
Yeah, I was expecting crazy stuff. Okay.
Misses the tech chase.
Yeah. Yeah, Super Cat Meow is not at all tech chasing. He's just going for reads.
Amazing up air by GCB.
Yeah.
He's now in clear lead, but
Nipple Spike?
Captain Falcon can... Oh my god.
Becker, this should be a stop. Just roll up.
That's a stop.
Yep. Supercat Meow bring
4% for Supercat Meow.
Supercat Meow is it's really
he
bringing
has to
the back
keep
for
his
team.
Momentum. So he can rack up damage as much as possible, but GCB won't
down
let
there,
him at only 2%.
Nice.
Wow, this is such an exciting crew battle, man.
It's very close.
Yeah, both teams were at a disadvantage at one point. Supercat Meow bringing it back for his own team. No, Cologne has been at a disadvantage
yes.
all the time, might be.
Yes.
Okay. Tries to follow him, misses his bit. Oh, no jump!
Very nice.
And that's a stock roll.
Yeah.
That's it. 61%.
Supercat Meow working for his team. Oh, that could have been a grab back throw and maybe a gimp.
Yeah, GCB won't let.
Yeah. He misses that
so
easy edge guard. I feel like GCB is nervous, man. Look at him. An up air, should see him. Yeah. Last stock, rock transformation.
No, it's. It's the worst transformation.
Worst transformation. Yeah,
Supercat
Meow just waited out. Supercat Meow does not want to go into the pit at least.
I think none of them wants to.
Well, I think Fox is fine in the pit. Do not go.
Oh my god.
Oh, he's just
he's
not
approaching,
there.
But.
And now go back. He got more damage than he took, so that's a good trade.
No! Oh, dangerous! Dangerous in the pit!
Don't!
Yeah.
This
yeah,
is so crazy.
Okay, back ass. Alright, he waited out the transformation.
Yeah, going
that
back
was
to neutral.
Fine for a Supercat Meow. no jump? He's still living. No jump!
Oh my god. No, he misses the edge cut, but still gets a punish.
Is that it?
Knee! That's it!
Supercat Meow
oh
does it!
Oh my god! Great job by Supercat Meow.
He just took six stocks
that's
with
amazing.
Losing only
amazing
three.
Amazing job.
Chanting town because
yes.
he took him to town. Good job by Supercat Meow, man.
To F Smash Town.
Wow. Good job by the Munster team.
Yeah.
They really played well. All of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, they did good work. Yeah.
Supercat did a great job.
Yeah, he carried. This is why he was their anchor.
Meister Yiga and.
No, four stock in the cruise. He left with four stocks, of course.
Okay.
All right. So you heard it from the man himself, Liva Torju. We're going for a break. Liva told only us.
Okay.
All right, so we're going for a break.